agenda was our discussion planning for the picnic, which is scheduled for June 5th. So you do have it going. How's the site going to work?
So far, it seems to be okay. You've already got two people watching.
Don't bump the ladder. Okay, spring picnic scheduled for June 15th. Saturday, June 15th, Browning Park in West Branch. Thanks to David's scheduling that for us over there. We have a lot of things to think about tonight, and I think, you know, are we going to provide food? Are we going to make it a fundraiser? Who are we going to invite? Things like that. So, what are your thoughts on?
What were the times again? It was 3 to 9.
Well, we got 3 p.m.
3 to 9.
That's 3 to 9.
We have it from 3 to 9, so I thought we'd start at 3, and depending who all shows up, and then it runs till midnight. Anybody will kick us out probably. So, and the idea, the reason for doing it on that date was because of the Pride Parade in Iowa City, hoping that there would be some presidential candidates perhaps attending that or some other notables, and we could invite them to come over. And I have sent out some invitations already, and I'll try to contact every campaign to let them know about it.
I hit up Tulsi's campaign and Bernie's, and then I tried to hit up Warren's campaign, but they didn't have a little button.
She's not on your mailing list, so she
didn't get the sense. Now, as you might know, today, or within the last day or two, Rita Hart decided to run for David's club sack seat. So I've got her phone number from 2 years ago when she was running with Hubble, or just before the last campaign. I got her cell phone number, so I called and left her a message to get back to me, and I told her about the June 15th event. So hopefully we can get it on her schedule when she can come.
Yes. That's also June 15th. I was thinking the thing is that the day of action.
Yes, and that's great. Yeah, that worked out good.
That ties in. That's the day Joni Ernst is kicking off her reelection campaign, and the Iowa United Party is trying to get other county parties to kick off some event. So it's fortuitous
sure.
that it had landed on the same day.
Right, and Hal gets the email being said, so you guys already got something planned for the day of action. So it fell on the right day for us.
Zach Walls is always in that right grade, so.
Well, you know what? Zach Walls tells me he can't even come to our event because apparently his girlfriends and him have a wedding they have to go to that day.
Oh, shoot.
So I asked him about the Pride Parade. I said, aren't you going to be in that? And he said, no. They've got to go somewhere far off, apparently, for a wedding, and so he won't be available.
Has he considered running the
Lobsox
position?
That's what
he's
talking about.
Well,
but now that Rita hurts him, he won't.
Yeah.
Early on, I heard that if Rita runs, he wouldn't. That's what I heard early on.
That's okay. He needs a year to win.
He needs a year to win.
I think he could win, but have you thought about Janice Weiner might run?
She might. Never know.
But she's carrying around the papoose on her back now. She's got custody of her grandmother.
So what do you think about, should we provide food, try to make it a fundraiser? What are your thoughts?
It's 3 to 9.
They need some munchies of some sort.
Munchies. I was wondering if we wanted to do something like that, something snackish and do hors d'oeuvres all day, and just have people bring in like snack stuff, because people are going to be coming and going between Iowa City and stuff, so I don't know if sitting down and having a whole schedule planned out with a meal at this time and everything.
A meal is probably not the best thing because you can't spread a meal over four.
What about burgers and dogs though?
Yeah, that's what I was just getting to think too.
Yeah.
They have a lot of
I can set a grill. I can set up a grill and
do they have a
barbecue as requested?
Place the barbecue.
You can set them up.
Bring in charcoal and just
what?
I don't know if they have. You can set up a grill. I don't think they already have grills there.
I don't think so.
I meant like this. Pit type thing with the charcoal, you throw charcoal in.
Yeah, they don't have any like
that. If they don't, well, it wouldn't be hard to bring a grill over and just, but I like the idea of maybe just, if you do hamburgers and hot dogs, then you could just keep throwing them on as the day
goes on. As needed.
Right. depending on the size of crowd, and then if you have
leftovers.
And if you
and they're frozen patties and hot dogs and you throw them right back in somebody's freezer.
Yep, exactly.
Exactly, that's right. That's right.
Plus it's always like 100 degrees that day, so you don't want to have a lot of stuff sitting out. So.
Yeah, that's right. So and then you just make it up as time goes on. And, and
10 bucks.
Do we
keep your hamburgers?
Is there any way we would want to make this a fundraiser, or?
Well, if we're going to sell burgers and hot dogs, we just did.
Yeah.
So we, well, I didn't say, but we certainly don't want to. we don't want to provide them free because Doug doesn't have enough money for that. So. Okay, so what's your thoughts on how you want to set up a fundraiser? You want to so much ahead, so much person, or just?
We're gonna, if I was.
Just for the food, just charge for the food.
I'm gonna bring a grill and cook as needed, buy it as an a la carte menu as needed basis.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It will be hit up as a fundraiser, then people will think that they'll think of it as just buying food.
Right. I mean, you can have donation things, but you don't have any like. I mean,
so
all we all
have
we,
a set price.
What we care about more is that they become active in the party.
Right.
Yeah. And
right.
If they can't afford to donate, that's fine.
Sure.
But I think we need every chance we can to raise money, because I think we've got to put some money in. We need money incoming this year and next year. I would like to see the supervisors us donate at least $3,000 to their campaign. We need to get our name out there and get them in there, and we need some Democrats in there. And any chance we can for a fundraiser or donation box, we need to do it and start it this year.
So, thinking about doing hamburgers, hot dogs. That sounds like a good plan.
It doesn't take a whole lot. We can chips. We have Costco and pop, and
water. Costco bottled water.
Give them a little wine. Those wallets come out.
Chips, water, hot dogs, or hamburger, and
beer wine.
True.
Okay.
Larry, at that point, could we even ask for to be sustaining members, or would they like to?
So, I think we could make that.
They have the papers there that they
can
sign out.
Yes.
And I think we don't have to give them a free whatever. It's $100 and
I guess
for a couple of
them. Don't
do anything like that. I think they should be willing
to sustain. Do we want to set up a committee then to take care of the preparation for the food and stuff? Is there anybody interested in being on a committee to be able to help with that?
Okay.
David, Aaron, and probably say, we're good. There's your committee.
Do you think we'd have t-shirts by then? Because we could sell some.
What?
Would we have t-shirts with them?
Who did the t-shirts last time?
Oh,
what
right.
Did we got left from last time we got them?
Do we have, I don't know where those t-shirts are.
Laura.
Laura have them?
Does she?
I'll bet Laura has them.
We'll have to, if we got some t-shirts, we'll certainly try to sell them. Good idea.
I wish we had buttons. I need to get buttons made, buttons.
Yeah, but a lot of people don't want to pin those buttons in their clothes.
My daughter uses her backpack at school for her political display. She has her Jody for Iowa button on there, her Rainbow Ally button, ACLU button, pretty much says what she is.
Okay, so anything else that we need to put on the plans or do as far as planning for that picnic? Get the food.
Entertainment?
Well, I think entertainment is going to be hopefully will come in like guest speakers.
But anytime you have some music going on.
Unless you want to dance or something.
Yeah, right.
But.
Put your flute, Dave.
Play a couple Irish tunes.
Yeah.
We'll invite as many candidates as we can, and sure hope we get some to come in and speak, and they'll have an opportunity to speak to the group. And we can maybe hopefully find that out ahead of time, far enough ahead of time to advertise and publicize that too.
You might so. Be able to get a musician.
Well, even just some CDs playing or something. Live music.
Musician would be good.
Oh, it is, but I think.
Now, Jody had somebody for her event last year. I don't know, does anybody know whether she's thinking about running again?
Hope so.
No, she just signed up to be the head, regional head for Bernie.
She can still run.
She, yeah, when I talked to her, that was her focus.
Yeah, if Kaufman runs, drops out, then that's an open seat then. We need somebody. She did pretty good last year.
And then we put her name on the ballot whether she wants to go or not. We get the signatures, we just turn it in. Guess what, Jody, you're on the ballot.
She's liking not being involved right now.
Yeah, give her a break.
She's really liking going out and working for Bernie at White Hand.
Well, a year from now, we'll know whether Bernie's gonna have a chance. And then she might, well, after the Iowa caucus, she may be freed up to say, I'm gonna run, you know, and that's a year away.
And we only hope that Bobby runs for Congress. So if he runs, he's done in the state.
That would get him out of our hair.
Yeah.
Well, to some extent.
Yeah. For a while.
If we could defeat him, get a Democrat to take Lopez's place, that would get rid of him for good. Well, not for good. Never say that about him.
No, no, he's a writer.
Okay. Dave, if you want to check on some music, if you, you know, come up with some, I don't think anybody'd object to having a little live music where it would hurt anything and it wouldn't have to be for 6 hours, but you know, even if
they... Save a lot more sets for you.
Yeah, there you go.
Even if they were there just for a couple hours.
You ought to know. Good pull.
Do we get a mic and a speakers for people to talk or...
We'll have that.
Get something?
David's still got one. Yeah. Good set, so... So that's good. Anything else we need to do as far as the spring picnic's concerned? I think that was one of the main things we had to get settled today.
Right, committee's been formed, I think we can move on.
Okay, move on to, just gonna do a, fair booth. Cedar County Fair Booth coming up in July. We set up a committee last time, Linda, Sarah, and Aaron, to come up with ideas. Come up with some ideas for the fair booth.
Was there any talk about it in the past month?
Yes. While we're out picking up trash. We wanted to dump, but we figured we can't do that.
I don't know about that.
You can't get that in there.
Mm-hmm. Maybe out on the grounds.
Well, we were going right outside the building and on the inside and sell tickets to throw
ball. I would actually like to see that at, you know, our big second district fundraiser dump here collected.
Trump doesn't get this tariff settled and the farmers get more angry, maybe we'd get a Trump costume and have somebody sit in it.
Isn't he
going to
bail the farmers out again with
billions? Oh, he's
going to
bail.
So, as an alternative to the dunking Trump and the dunk booth, what I thought we might do is a 50-50 raffle, and we can generate, print up caricatures of some famous past presidents, maybe two or three caricatures. Anybody who registers to vote gets a free raffle ticket, and then they get three chances to guess the name of the president. I'm shooting for younger generation kids here who might not know what Herbert Hoover looks like, or
Martin Van Buren's pretty.
And so, if with each correct guess, they would get another ticket. But at the same time, we'd be generating maybe some donations through a 50-50 raffle. And then Aaron had a great idea where we have an actual straw poll and we set up canning jars for each of our candidates.
Actually, I was thinking straw.
And so we could just take a straw poll. Have information for the candidates there available, but it would be an opportunity to maybe generate a little interest in the younger candidates.
Yeah, we could get the young kids to stop by for something to get those young kids stopped.
The raffle tickets cheap enough, if we make them $1 instead of making somebody have to fork over $5, then
what are they going to win if they?
The 50-50 raffle,
they win
half
the
money.
Oh, gotcha.
Do we have to contact the state for that?
Yeah, we have to have a license probably. Huh?
Mm-hmm. Great for gaming.
If they're getting a license and being going to be Matthews Building during the fair. I'm not so certain there's not going to be some certain members of the fair board that are going to bitch about that.
I could think of a few.
One just got on this past year who I've already told them we were in here setting up to kiss my ass. So.
Anyway, yeah, so I will check on that, but I think we've checked on it before on doing some gambling like that, and it is fairly expensive to get that permit license from the state.
Who would we call about that? Because I can call them.
Secretary of State, maybe.
If that sounds up to you.
County treasurer can get the ball rolling all right, though, can't she?
The county treasurer?
I mean, as far as a license for it? For a raffle?
Well, I don't know. I doubt if our county treasurer.
But didn't we get that through that?
I think it got through the state.
Iowa Democratic Party, didn't we do that?
Did we use theirs?
We might have used theirs.
I lost my wife. I don't remember if she called the Secretary of State.
Okay.
And this is for the fair?
Forgot the treasurer.
This raffle?
Not me.
I didn't put it on the agenda.
What?
Treasurer's report.
We'll have to go back to it. Anyway.
Because there wasn't one last month, and you made everything off last month's meetings.
I made up some minutes. Sounds like you've got some good ideas started, some good plans started. We've got another month, June, to have another meeting and finalize some things.
I think it's important to keep it simple and not spend a whole lot of money, you know, putting the booth together. I think if we just, if we just play it cool and promise people an opportunity to win cash.
Start getting all the
political posters. Lynn Chapman down at the lumberyard is on the, she's been the secretary or some such thing. That's where I've been getting the applications for a booth. So I'll talk to Lynn and get an application. And then I think it's $125. I'll get hold of Doug and maybe Doug can. What we might want to do tonight is go ahead and have a motion to approve spending. As far as I know, it's $125, unless they've changed it.
Mm-hmm. No, it's still.
I would say, just go ahead and make, we'll get a motion to just approve paying the application fee for a booth at the fair, but it'll be around $125. If we got that approved, then Doug can get with me and take care of that one, just so I get the application. So,
whatever costs, make a motion, go just set up the get her spot now.
Yep, very good. Motion, is that a motion, Steve?
Yes. So
this is first time. Second by David. So motion to purchase or pay for an application for a fair booth. Any discussion on that? Any more discussion?
Nope,
not all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And opposed? Okay. That's our first official move to getting a fair booth, and we'll talk about this again next month. You guys can maybe get together a little more on your plans and work out some things. Yes.
As far as the Facebook goes, do we going while we talk about our treasurer's report?
That's a very good point.
It's all public anyways, right? We have to.
Yeah.
Treasurer's.
Okay.
That's public. I don't know. We don't
unless you want to spend it on something.
Yeah.
Oh, it is?
The committee's finances.
No, I just don't want the pre-pubs to know what we're up to.
Yes.
Well, it's not a big deal.
Yeah, I think it's public. Since I forgot treasurer's report tonight, Douglas is going to report on what we've got in the church.
All right, fasten your seatbelts.
Nothing's changed.
Nothing's changed.
Okay. And so
you still have the same $833.
Well, should we accept your report?
Okay, got that. Sarah? Motion and a second to accept the treasurer's report. All in favor say aye.
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 And opposed?
Okay,
very good. All right. We're going to, next item that I put on the agenda was a roadside cleanup report, just a report on, we had, I forget how many people
nine.
Altogether, was there about?
Nine
people altogether?
I believe so. Mm-hmm.
And Amelia came, and Tom from the Delaney campaign was here. Aaron and Steve were there. I was there.
Sarah and Maggie.
Deb and her daughter, too.
Yep, Deb and her daughter.
I forgot all about it.
So anyway, we had a nice group, and it was an hour and a half, maybe.
That was by far the biggest group and the shortest turnaround we've had to do that two monster trials.
Yeah.
So.
We generated
with
a lot of bags. It was
and
some of the stuff people were throwing out. Oh my goodness.
But yeah, it was
Would you like to elaborate on that?
I found a bong.
It was a bong.
It's a pipe.
Just a little one there.
Just a little one.
They first threw that out about 30 seconds before they got
pulled.
Two-foot artificial Christmas tree with the light still on it.
I thought we'll have somebody moving.
Yeah, we had a good group, and it went pretty good, and the weather was good.
Tom's making a mistake. It wasn't a hot day.
It wasn't a rainy part, so.
He thinks Bush Light is the official beer of Iowa.
Yeah.
Hard to debate that. The number of Bush Light bottles picked up.
Right.
Next item on the agenda was to talk about the input, get some discussion input on the design of a new website. That was before I knew Deb wasn't going to be here tonight. So.
Table it.
Okay, motion to table that. We'll put it on next month's agenda.
Okay.
I'll
feed it up. Let's table it. Next, I thought maybe we'd do a little report on the Elizabeth Warren visit. And I think that was quite successful. I'm guessing 150 people or something like that.
Something like that, yeah.
And it was stuffed 100 of them into the family restaurant.
I was quite surprised I didn't see it in the paper unless I missed it.
But there was a picture in the paper of her standing on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
What page?
The article.
Kind of in the back.
Yeah, it was there. They didn't get any pictures from the inside, which is just fine. But anyway, I think the people really liked her visit and her speech and enjoyed seeing her here in Tipton. So hopefully we'll be able to get some more candidates to come through Tipton.
Well, then Christmas the paper.
Speaking of that, I did send out by email this afternoon, this evening, Mayor Pete is going to be in Solon on Saturday, this coming Saturday, May 18th. 12:30 to 2:30 p.m. He's going to be in Solon at an event. He's going to be at the.
You have to reserve your spot, and they will display the address.
Oh yes, that's
right. Address provided upon sign up. And I sent the information to you, including the link to sign up, so you will all have that link on your email at home when you get back, so you can sign up, and they'll send you the address. And I've never been to one like Warren's campaign ran that, where you had to sign in, and then that was the only way you could get in, and then they get a.
We had a little conversation with Amelia because we thought it was a little ridiculous. Because we had people coming up who had already RSVP'd online, yeah. And it was cold outside and windy, and people just wanted to, go stand in the sun, and here we are like, no, get on your phone, and you have to do this, and it was really fidgety. Yeah. So we told her, we're like, if they should get something on their email that shows that they RSVP, that's all they should show us. Yeah. Here it is. And then we give them a sticker, and then they go get in line. But the whole double sign
thing. Yeah, it was kind of a rigmarole, and so I don't know how complicated this will be, but you've got the information on your emails or your computer.
Hey, Larry, just backtrack. I looked up here for the state of Iowa for the license or permit for gaming, or whatever you want to call them, for a 14-day qualified organization, it's $15.
Oh, awesome.
That's not bad at all. Mm-hmm.
You got to go to the state of Iowa.
This is through what department?
Inspections and appeals.
Yeah.
Okay, there you go.
Okay.
Very good. Now, if you guys want to look into that, and if you decide you want to go that way with the 50-50, $15 is not a big investment.
That 14 days, I covered the whole fair.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and a bunch of gamblers around. But farmers are all gamblers. They should all be buying. That's better than planting soybeans.
Most people give their portion back if it's going back to charity.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. Down to the next item is discussing of any other kind of fundraising we might be doing. I do really want to reach out to the people we had on the sustaining fund a year ago, because I'm pretty sure I think we could get some pretty good success back from those people and hit them not only for our sustaining fund for 2019, but also let them know about the event over in West Branch. So if they would like to come over, and then with the anticipation of perhaps we'll have some presidential candidates, I sure would think we'd get some. I don't know. I mean, I know there's lots
of them.
Now, what
out of 24, you're fine. You think
do you recall what month you started sending them out last year?
It was like a month before the fundraiser, wasn't it?
I'd have to look.
You're talking September?
I don't know if I. No, it was way earlier than that.
When are you sure?
No. Yeah, it was earlier than September when I sent them out in person.
Isn't our fundraiser in October, or am I thinking wrong?
But do you have your records from last year when we started getting those stadium funds?
Yeah, I don't think I have any of these.
Okay.
Larry, do you recall how many responses you got from the second go-round?
The second go-round? Not near as many as the first time around, but we did get some. I sent out 100 the first time, and 100 letters, and I think we got back close to 50% on that one. And they either were $50 or $100 donors. So then we tried another 50, and that one was probably, I don't know if we got more than 10 people responding.
I think it was the end of August.
End of August when I sent it out, started getting them in. Okay, so yeah, I thought it was like maybe August. We might have sent them out in August, but you know, we could do it this time of the year and still have our fall fundraiser.
Well, I guess what I'm getting at is your intention was to do it annually. Let's pick a date and do it annually every year. Okay. Whether it's July when you maybe wrote them up last year or what, you know what I'm saying? You don't pound them beforehand too hard.
That's not a bad idea, and that's fine. We could do that this summer going into the fall fundraising time. And we could still probably try to get a contact in the spring, maybe even a postcard, to let them know about this event in West Branch.
Well, not only that, but I'm imagining all these people that you had that were respondents, you know, personally.
For the most part.
What a phone call.
Sure.
Because we still, I'm guessing we don't have any letterhead or anything printed up sent out yet, do we?
No, we don't.
So.
Oh, and that's not a bad idea. I think if Betty would probably help me with that, would you?
I'd rather send a letter because then they've got something.
Well, but we're not wanting to ask for money on this one. Basically, we just want to touch base with them and let them know about the spring fundraiser. And just,
why not ask for money then?
Well, because Steve just said if we're going to do an annual sustaining fund drive,
he
suggested we do it a year from when we did the last one, which would be send out those sustaining fund requests in August, say, for the fall. That's what Steve's suggesting anyway. In the meantime, if we could get them to come to that picnic, we could make a little money off of that there. You know, that we could still make a little money from that.
Actually, the first one, covering you sent out the agenda of all the events, and maybe it stirs some interest that way. And then hit up for the money. Year goes by quick.
Well, we've already established we're going to have donation bins out there for people to throw money in anyway.
Yeah.
So that's a foregone conclusion. At least something's going to be there, given the opportunity to leave us money.
What I don't have with these sustaining fund members is I don't have email addresses, which that would be a good excuse to call them.
Mm-hmm.
And see if they've got an email address so we could keep them updated on events. And then I can send them our scheduled events and activities.
Let them know there's a Facebook account. Let them know soon there's going to be a website. Let them know we have a Twitter account if these sustaining fund participants do indeed do things like that.
Mm-hmm. I had somebody we could also probably reach out, and I've got the list of the 2016 caucus attenders, and we could expand what we were doing, and we should reach out to all of those people because they're the most active Democrats we've got. Obviously, I had somebody last night was saying that caucus can't come any too soon. She says we gotta get rid of that guy. So
that's too true.
But anyway, okay. Would you be interested in helping me contact one way or the other? Contact those sustaining fund members. Is that something anybody else would like to help with? Contacting you. Did you say you had to help?
Oh, I did think I don't have a choice.
There we go. Sharon volunteered. So, yeah, the three of us will take a look at that list. We'll sit down and do some phone calling and reach out, try to get some email addresses so we can start contacting them. I put them on my email contact. And yeah, the more we can expand that, the better off we are, get people's information out.
We'll get some interested and involved too.
Oh, yeah. Well, they're sitting out there, they don't know what's, yeah, they don't know what's going on, and they're frustrated with Trump and angry like we are about things. So yeah, it's good for them to know that somebody's trying to do something.
Have we ever sent anything out to all the registered Democrats in the county to inform them what's going on?
Well, I thought we talked about that at the last meeting where we talked about sending out like a newsletter that had all of the...
I can start working on that with MailChimp because I have some familiarity with that. The only problem is I do need an okay, like people actually need to register for it, otherwise I can get spam blocked. I don't want to get kicked out.
So are you talking through email?
Mm-hmm.
By email?
Like via email.
Or are you talking of something?
I'm talking about registered mail.
Actual letter.
Not registered, but actual snail mail.
No.
Well, it would be a rather expensive process. Mm-hmm. 3,000 some Democrats, I mean, you're talking $1,500 postage.
Or even just a postcard, you know.
A
bulk rate postcard, 50 cents or less.
Cheap.
No, it's, nothing's cheap.
But I still think people like a letter
but,
or something written.
Even if it just has a website address on it and a couple of key dates.
Yeah, because...
And contact information.
From the last last voting session, when I'm sitting there at those polling sites and seeing more than three quarters of the registered voters not showing up at the poll.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It just drove me nuts. If we'd had all those people show up, we could have got Jody in.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I mean, it's there's got to be a reason why they're not coming to the polls.
But the list of registered voters that were kicked out, the high percentage, that they weren't at that address.
Well, some of them weren't,
quite a few.
The list of registered voters per precinct that we had last year, that entire list, almost in its entirety, was misinformation. It was almost all garbage. Mm-hmm. I would bet 15% of it was correct.
Well, I think that it's different now because the last election used the electronic ID procedure, so there was a verification of the information, at least the address.
So it's updated now.
And the list can be obtained. And curtailed, or you can get the list from the Secretary of State, and then you can slice it and dice it so that you're only looking at the actual voters from the previous election. So if 7,000 registered Democrats, if we had 3,000 who actually voted, at least we've got that as a base to start from.
Well, this committee has access to VAN through the state party.
I don't know if VAN is the same thing as the Secretary of State.
It's all based off the Secretary of State's report.
Okay, one way or the other, that's...
So it'd be free to us.
Well, the people that voted then would have updated correct addresses, mm-hmm. but the problem was
the ones who didn't
only 40% of the Democrats, or 30 or 40% of the Democrats actually voted, so you're still looking at 70% that mm-hmm. you don't know whether that's correct or not. So it's a struggle. That way, and then
but it's a start.
Yeah, that's all we're looking for. It's a start.
Step by step.
Sure. Oh yeah.
But the ones that you're sending out, the other 60%, that's a big expense that you're wasting. Now, when I got letters returned on my campaign, I gave them to Lauren. She tried to update things as we went, so we got some of them done. But I had a limited field that I sent them to. I wasn't sending them.
You got 4,000 Democrats. That's about what it is in the county, 4,000 or something, somewhere like that. And if you even if you got 20% out that many mailers and 20% of them are kicked back because of bad addresses or whatever, that's a lot of wasted money and time and effort. So, I don't know what the answer is, but we need to start somewhere.
Somewhere we've got to somehow reach out to people somehow.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of names I see on the list that didn't show up, I knew them, and I don't know why they didn't. Some of them I understand why it was bad weather. And they were by West Branch, and probably didn't want to go out in the weather. But even if something like that, we reach out to them beforehand and say, okay, let's get an absentee ballot.
did a lot of that.
Oh, we did a ton of that.
Trying to hand out the absentee ballots.
I mean,
every Democratic door that was legitimate in this county got hit at least twice.
Well, is it cheaper or is it not?
Yeah.
We need to look into this.
I have a question. Why can't we coordinate with the various campaigns? Instead of doing this all on our own, can't we in some way get involved with the various campaigns and pull data?
That's what we did last election cycle.
The IDP coordinated campaign thing that every list they kicked out to us after they came down said, we need to do it this way.
Well, IDP lists were never any good.
No, exactly.
So that's why I'm
and
asking
then they did,
if we
they did
can
nothing.
Use,
they never, yeah.
If we can use our resources along with the various candidates, I mean, there's a slew of them, and they're all doing work of some sort or another, but they're all keeping it close to the vest, evidently.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we reach out and see if we can't get this coordinated?
Now, even if we knew the voters that voted last time, contact them, whether it be each precinct chair, whatever it is, or contact those people in your precinct and say, hey, I see you voted last time. Are you planning on voting this time? And if so, could you help us out?
Sure.
And call a couple of these people for us and find out. Go talk to your neighbors.
But that's some of our problem, too, is we have people we have precinct spots that aren't filled, or people who don't, even though that's technically part of the job as a precinct chair.
Yeah, but if you don't have a precinct chair.
Is to contact the people within your precinct.
But I don't know the people in my precinct. How do I get a list?
I can get you a list.
Give me a list.
Awesome. I'm on it.
Give me a list.
I'll hook you up.
No, I say a list.
So yeah, it's good that we're starting to talk about this 18 months before the election.
Yeah,
I mean, rather than
if we go through the disaster we did last time around, it's going to be awful.
We got to be ready to kick some.
So anything we can gather this year, the information, and start collecting that information, contact information, and all of this mm-hmm. far ahead is pretty good. So,
interject something. It occurred to me that we've got these events that are done throughout the year, the fair and the roadside cleanup and the picnic and all of that stuff. It seems to me that really when those interactions happen, when we get people involved who don't know one way or the other that there's a Democratic Party here in Cedar County or just aren't informed, that those things happen more at events where we might be. Maybe what we need to do instead is start presenting ourselves as like a more community service oriented group that puts us out there more. And I don't know, because I'm still the new kid on the block. I don't know what's been done in the past. But like the roadside cleanup I thought was great, but it's clear out of town. You don't have an opportunity to interact with people. What if we did roadside cleanup right here in town, where we could have, Cedar County Democrats on our backs or whatever. Or we did some type of, community service for,
I would like to collect, as they keep kind of tying it back to what's going on at the State House, they're cutting education costs.
Right.
Why not set up a table? Set up a table to drop off markers and crayons?
Yes.
For the
backpack
kids.
Because that
puts
us
in
a good light,
to
and people start seeing the Democrats are representing a good opportunity. They're taking care of their community, and it's putting us out there being more visible.
We actually did that at the county fair.
Winchester.
We actually had tubs there for each of the different school districts in the county, and people could drop off school supplies, which they then took to the schools. Probably elementary age school supplies.
I think that's awesome, except that people go to the fair to have fun. I think if we set up in front of Family Foods, or we put an announcement out that we're going to be at the library, or Walmart, or the back parking lot of the courthouse, you can drive right through and drop stuff off. We could do canned food drives. We could do, whatever. But
getting ourselves out there and letting the community see that the Democrats are all about helping the community.
Good idea.
What the hell are the Republicans doing?
Well, that's a good idea. Like for school supplies, you could do that just prior to school starting August, sometime in early August.
Right.
Just have a day when you're going to set up at Walmart. You know?
Yeah, I think Walmart go for it because they're going to buy them right there. And
yeah.
Exactly.
Drop them off.
Go in and drop them off.
Yep.
And you can hand people, I wonder if they would do like some kind of coupon thing. Here's a coupon for 50 cents off,
yeah.
You know, two boxes of crayons. Drop one off here.
They're pretty cheap though.
Yeah.
Quarter,
29 cents,
yeah.
That time.
Yeah.
And if you collected things that kids would be using in elementary grades.
I'll walk right by those Girl Scout cookies, but if I go past and they say we're collecting food and I'm headed into the store, I absolutely buy two or three cans of something or a couple boxes of something. I'm happy to drop it off. And as long as they're not asking for cash or asking me to buy cookies, I'll participate.
Sure. We can do a drive for food.
The
food pantry, for example.
Yep.
You know.
Get a
like
list from the school as to what K-8 or whatever it needs.
The animal shelter.
I
can
tell you.
We could do a drive.
There's
an
animal shelter.
Bring
that up.
There's another thing.
Animal
that,
shelter would be a good one.
I've
got something bring up on
the Backpack Buddy program.
They get a lot of
mm-hmm.
I would wonder if they could use some more volunteers sometimes. Maybe
they could.
Maybe the Democrats could get together. We could volunteer on a rotating basis.
Yeah.
Two or three of us go in on... They do it on Thursdays during the school year over at the Lutheran Church, I think. They go in and they pack up all this stuff for kids, and if you know the program, that they take down, and there's certain kids who are low income,
mm-hmm.
that they send
it's
them home with a backpack full of stuff.
For the weekend, yeah.
Absolutely.
But you can just hear Tipton, and I know that Bennett does it, and I'm sure some of the other towns do too.
North Cedar does.
They have it in West Branch.
Yeah.
How do you answer the criticism that, sure, I'd like to help these kids, but that stuff that's in their backpack, they're never going to see it once they get home. Their parents are going to take that stuff, and the kids won't see it.
Deb Vandergast can answer that question for you. She's got her finger on the pulse of stuff like that because she interacts with those parents on a daily basis.
Hmm. And, you know, there are no doubt are some parents are like that. And let the kid go hungry, but there may be parents who would also eat some of that food, and that's not the end of the world either. But,
no, but there's a perception out there that
I know.
It's just bleeding heart liberals wasting money because
you're
the kids
not
are not benefiting.
So
you're
here's
not
something
get their
that
lunch anyways, right? Anybody that is like that,
they're not gonna. Yeah, you're right.
Well, that's
the
consensus in our county, though. I mean,
but people who offer that argument tend to influence people who are undecided.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't have an answer for it, then you're kind of turning your back and hoping that things will work out okay.
I would say one tactic that you can use is make readily edible food. Don't put, you know, bananas, oranges, apples, things that kids can open, and yeah, fruits and,
yeah,
and
I know they put a lot of fruit cups and stuff.
They don't have to cook.
Right, but they don't have to prepare. But what about, is there like a church or community kitchen around here where we can hold a volunteer thing where we actually teach kids to prepare food? Because that's one of my soapbox issues is that kids aren't being taught to cook.
Right. There's no hope back anymore.
Right.
No.
And so because of that, and I talked to Zach Walls about this, because of that, it's a fast food generation. And that is leaching into the healthcare issues,
mm-hmm.
because kids aren't learning how to prepare their own foods. What if we took on, I talked to Betty about this too, what if we took on some type of a larger scale project where we actually had like an after school program where kids could come and learn how to prepare food?
You know, they teach them, they have a cooking class at school, and the kids have to take a teenage.
No,
they
I
teach
know
them
my
how to make pizza and a cake and...
Did you say they don't do those classes anymore?
Yeah, West Branch doesn't have.
West Branch limited a whole bunch of stuff.
Tipton does have a home ec class, and my son took it.
Yeah.
And he enjoyed it.
I was going to say,
life skills. Life skills.
Yeah.
My son enjoyed it quite a bit, but he got paired up, and on the day when they were actually preparing food, his partner was the one who got to prepare it. He was stuck with doing the dishes.
Yeah.
So, but it was not, they but didn't do like
food.
A lot of it. No, they actually made scrambled
my son,
eggs or something.
Well, I mean, they made that, but they made pizza and a cake, and it was all junk. You know, they didn't teach them.
Right.
I sent in steaks for one day. I said, this is bullshit. I sent steaks, and I said, I called the teachers, you teach them how to fix meat.
How to fix meat.
And they had steak.
Are you donating?
Yeah. That's stupid.
Okay. What's you know, that's a lot of good ideas, and I think that sounds pretty positive in the group that there's something we ought to start thinking about getting more involved in community support.
I want to throw one more thing out there. There's a dog, the kennel at the pound here in town, and I was talking to Amelia, and I was telling her that I've been involved with the transporting of rescue dogs to new fosters and new homes. And how well that's much fun that's been. And she called me back and said she talked to Elizabeth and Elizabeth has Bailey, the yellow lab, and that if we wanted to plan something doing dogs, whether it be a Bailey's run or some sort of program to help raise money for the local, that they would be full support behind us to do it. So.
So my son is part of a group at the high school called Others Before Us. They've picked up trash at the fairgrounds. They've planted. They've done some work at the senior citizens home. That's what they're looking for. They're trying to do some kind of a fundraiser where they walk dogs. But I wonder if they'd be willing to switch that up and donate their time to. The animal shelter instead.
Why don't you two work with Amelia and see what you can work out, and if you can come up with something, bring it back to us. I mean, even if you don't wait till next meeting, let us know on email what's coming up, and if we can. You know, I've been belonging to other organization or two where, you know, in between regular meetings, if there's a decision that comes up, something comes up that we need to move forward on, take some sort of action, we just. Do it by email.
Mm-hmm.
Send out an idea, a proposal, and everybody, yes or no. You know, if it gets affirmative majority, then at least the group's approved it, we move ahead. So keep us informed what you come up with on that. But I think the community service thing has got a lot of good possibilities, and we should really be looking at that to start before this fall, before school. Then when the Backpack Buddy program starts up again, we should be on the ground. I do know one of the ladies that runs that, and I will talk to her about that and report back next month on the Backpack Buddy program.
Do we have t-shirts? Are there t-shirts? I mean, do I need to buy a t-shirt from somebody?
We need to find them.
Democrats?
I'll check with Laura and see what we have.
Okay.
Whether we should have some left from...
Providing that visibility during these where everybody else in unity that really
good idea. Mm-hmm. I'll check on that. And I did request caucus locations at the school, and I put in an application for them. So there's four precincts we'll be meeting at the Tipton High School. Have you applied for and got West Branch for two precincts? For both Springdale, Gower, and West Branch.
We'll get Bennett
and
Durant.
And you're
going to
work
week.
On Farmington and Inland.
We're waiting to hear back from
Sugar
Troy.
Creek, Sugar Creek, rather.
What, are you going to Clarence
and hit them? Yeah, if you would.
Sure.
You know, the superintendent, of course, North Cedar covers a wide area. I don't know if you know the superintendent, Doman.
No.
His name's Mark Doman. I've met him once or twice. But if you go to the superintendent's office and district office, and you may be able to arrange for a location in Loudoun, because that's where we had it last time, was in the school building at Loudoun. And you may be able to request one for that precinct as well, while you're at it, if you wouldn't mind.
Mm-hmm.
And then, I don't know about Mechanicsville, where they had theirs last time. The date is February 3rd, Monday, February 3rd, is caucus day. And make sure it has to be handicap accessible, but school buildings are handicap accessible.
And
so.
From 8 in the morning or not? What?
The caucus starts at 7, but you'll she'll want to have access to it as early as probably 5 o'clock. So if you need, you know, if you want to get through the caucus chair, she'll probably try to get there an hour early.
5 to 7.
After probably 9.
And yeah, it could run till at least 9. And
I think the last one, I kind of remember that in the cafeteria at the high school, and we're like,
what did we get ourselves into?
Cedar Rapids, Marion area, but last one that, what, 2016, didn't some of them last till like 1 o'clock in the morning?
With all these people running,
it's we hope we don't have 24 left in caucus.
Was someone joining today?
That would be a disaster.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I don't think they're done yet.
There's a couple more generic white guys out there that can jump in, you know
that. I'll see if I'll keep in touch with Rita Hart and see if we can get her down here for some activities and events. But she lives right across the county line, basically, mm-hmm. just over in Clint County.
It's Wheatland.
Yeah, Wheatland. So.
Right between Wheatland and Big Rock.
Yep. So it's kind of a home corner pretty strongly, but hopefully we'll see how this thing shakes out. But. Somebody said they had a candidate information they wanted to speak about.
So both of those two. Well, I've previously told you, Mary said she's been stopping by almost monthly and have lunch and talk about what's going on. And if anybody else needs a sheet of paper here, she's got a link here that they get together once a month and have a coffee type of thing and talk about a view of policy that Elizabeth's got running.
Okay.
The next one will be coming up here. So this she's had an issue now. Anyway, yeah, coffee group here. And you're invited to go to that. This next one's going to be on
college affordability and student loan debt plan.
Yep, that was we talked about a lot of stuff. And then she wanted to push the idea that if anybody knows a kid that would like to, or a young adult involved with internship. She apologized, she had a conflict tonight, and she didn't have her calendar. And I hope everybody's doing well.
What's the date? Well, you're going to sign up for the coffee. For the monthly coffee, you hit this link.
And
then you get all the information.
And she said that anybody going for an internship or gain political experience will be involved in politics, and it's great for a resume. And the one will get paid, so that's all.
Who are we talking about?
Elizabeth Warren.
Elizabeth Warren campaign.
Okay.
David.
No.
So Jody was supposed to be here to read this tonight. She's got a high school event.
Yeah.
Since launching our campaign, this is the Sanders campaign, more than 1.5 million people have said they're in, and of those 1.5 million, 25,000 of them are in Iowans. Additionally, since we launched, Senator Sanders has spoken directly to more than 9,000 Iowans in the events here in Iowa. On April 27th, the campaign had more than 5,000 volunteers organized and ran house parties across the country, with 70 of them in here in Iowa. We are hiring field staff and have already built out our field leadership teams, and we are setting up offices across the state. And we are launching a grassroots training happening on June 14th. Last I heard, they were paying their people $20 an hour. So,
wow.
if you have children,
sure.
High school kids,
Richard,
that makes a big
difference. Yeah, right.
So, that's it.
Good. And she's a regional director, and meaning
right. So
what,
she has
what area?
Johnson County, Cedar County, and Washington County.
Okay.
So.
Johnson, Cedar, and Washington.
Johnson's
well,
the big one. We're hoping to have an office set up in Iowa City like we did last time.
Yeah. So, I mean, she's doing this, is not going to keep her from running for the Iowa House. I don't think that will prevent her from doing that at all.
She probably get fun from his revolution.
There you go.
Pack.
Yep.
If she did.
I'll bet.
I wish you want to take back money though.
Yeah.
Well, we would just channel it into some of their form.
Just like everybody else does.
Revolution.
She handed us our check back from the airport last time.
Hers too.
Was there anything else? I think we've come to the bottom of my list. Anything else anybody'd like to bring up? I'm sorry. Oh yeah, Mary's letter that she brought to us. Okay.
Be sure of stuff. Be sure and read these. And most of them have a copy of my note on the third page. And if you want these published in the paper, you're going to have to call Stuart and tell him, because I called him yesterday to see if he was publishing them. And he said, not if only Mary Stuart asks. But if I hear from more people, I would probably do it. So you've got to call him, and I'd love to see him in the West Branch paper also.
He's very strong.
Yeah.
He already has these. He already has them.
Yes.
And
where will you see the paper this week?
I don't read the paper.
The Nate Wilhelm column was really a classic, though. That was something else that right about.
What it is Andy McKean writes a column about why he switched parties, which I was so thrilled about. Okay. Kaufman writes a guest column, just ripping Andy to pieces. And that's the second one. So then Nate Williams from Mount Vernon pops up and just rips Kaufman to pieces. I mean, it is priceless.
Yeah.
And people in Tifton need to read this.
Yeah.
So, call the paper.
I'll put an article in the paper about things we're doing and have done. But I don't do Facebook. So, and Deb does the Facebook thing primarily. But I mean, I think can anyone put stuff on our Facebook page?
No.
So we need to send, if you want something on there, send it to Deb. And I'll do the same, of course. And I do that on articles and stuff that I do. And I share the stuff that I get from campaigns. I share that try to share it with everybody. So then Deb will probably take this link and perhaps put it on Facebook, which would be a good thing, because then more and more people know about this Mayor Pete's event. So so we're just, that's how we go.
Maybe we should also be posting our agendas and minutes on the Facebook page.
Good.
Cat photos don't hurt either.
Cat photos don't hurt. Or did anybody see the dancing parrot recently?
Yes, I saw.
Yeah. I'm seconding the motion to adjourn.
Going down real fast.
Yeah, right. Okay, so the move to second to adjourn, all in favor.